Hey everyone, it's Alvaro Fuentes for the Stata YouTube channel, and in this video we would like to give you an introduction to the didregress and xtdidregress commands for fitting difference and differences models. So let's get started. In the most basic scenario where difference and differences estimation may be appropriate, we have an outcome y, and we observe the values of this outcome for two groups at two points in time. We also know that, at a time point between these two observations, an intervention or treatment or policy was applied. In this example, the average outcome of the control units, that is, the units that never experienced the intervention, increased at a particular rate between the two time points where we have data. Then, an important assumption we make is that the average outcome of the treated units would have followed the same trend had they not experienced the intervention. What we observe, however, is that the average outcome of the treated units in the second time period is higher than expected, and so we assume it was the intervention that caused the treated units to deviate from their original trend. The gap between what their average outcome would have been and what it actually is, we call the average treatment effect on the treated, or ATET. And as you can see on the plot, this is equal to what the difference is in the second time point minus what the difference was in the first time point, which is why this method is called difference in differences. An important distinction we have to make before we start our analysis is whether we're working with panel data, where the exact same units are sampled before and after the intervention, or with a repeated cross-section, where we have a different sample of units drawn from the same population at each time point. In Stata, we can then use the didregress command for analysis with repeated cross-sections, or the xtdidregress command for analysis with panel data. The datasets we will run into when using these commands can have three additional features. First, there is grouping, which could mean we have a dataset of patients grouped by the hospitals where they were treated, students grouped by the schools where they study, and so on. Importantly, the intervention is always applied at the group level, which means either all the members of a group eventually experience the intervention, or none of them do. And to let Stata know the grouping structure of our dataset, we use the group option of these commands, which is a required option even in the simplest setting where we have only two groups. Another possibility is having data for more than one time point before and after the intervention. Stata will notice the number of periods we have when we specify the time option of our command, and these additional observations can give us detailed information about the trend that the treated and control units followed over time. But the methods we're presenting in this video actually assume that the treatment effect is identical at every period after the intervention, so if you have data like this, you may want to test that assumption using, for example, the estatbdcomp command, or you may want to analyze your data with the heterogeneous difference in differences commands that we cover in another video. And finally, in some datasets, we will find that different treated groups experience the intervention at different time points. In such cases, Stata will notice the different cohorts simply by looking at our group and time variables in combination with our binary treatment variable. But again, keep in mind that the methods we're presenting here assume a homogeneous treatment effect over time and over cohorts, so if you have data like this, you may want to test these assumptions or analyze your data with the heterogeneous DID commands. We'll begin by opening hospdd.dta, which is a dataset of patients that visited their local hospital and were either exposed to an old admissions procedure or exposed to a new admissions procedure. Procedure here is our binary treatment variable. It is equal to 1 only for treated units and only after the intervention, and equal to 0 everywhere else. After their visit, these patients were asked to rate their satisfaction with the admissions procedure they experienced, and this satisfaction score is the outcome we will try to explain. In other words, these hospitals are wondering whether switching to a new admissions procedure had an effect on patient satisfaction. Looking at the month variable, we can see that we have 7 time periods, which are the months of January through July, and that the intervention started in April for every hospital that experienced it. And looking at the hospital ID variable, we can see that the new admissions procedure was only ever introduced in certain hospitals. In summary, for each of these patients, we know which hospital they visited, in which of the seven time periods they visited, what procedure they were exposed to, which is our treatment variable, and what satisfaction score they reported, which is our outcome variable. And because we do not have a patient ID variable telling us it was the same patient surveyed every month, our dataset is a repeated cross-section of patients. To estimate the effect of the new procedure on patient satisfaction, we go to statistics, causal inference treatment effects, continuous outcomes, difference in differences, DID. This opens a dialog box for the DID regress command, where we will select our dependent variable, satisfaction, and our binary treatment variable, procedure. And if we had any relevant covariates in this dataset, we could control for them here in the independent variables field. Next, we select our grouping variable, which are the hospitals, and the variable that indicates the time periods, which is month. And if we click Submit to run the command, Stata prints out the results on the results window. The command Stata issued is didregress, and then we have two parentheses. In the first one, we have our outcome variable, followed by any covariates we control for, in this case, none. And in the second parenthesis, we have just our treatment variable. The two options after the comma tell Stata that the intervention is administered at the level of the hospitals, and that the time variable is month. The output then begins with information about the treatment and time structure of the dataset. On the table, we can see that only 18 out of 46 hospitals switched to the new admissions procedure at some point. We can also see the earliest time and the latest time at which hospitals appear in the dataset with the old and new admissions procedure. And here, it's easy to see that the treated hospitals adopted the new policy as a single cohort, because no hospitals appear with the new admissions procedure any earlier or later than April. At the top of the coefficients table, Stata tells us we fit a difference in differences regression to repeated cross-sectional data, and then reports an average treatment effect on the treated of about 0.85. In other words, our estimate indicates that average patient satisfaction in the treated hospitals is 0.85 points higher than it would have been if none of the treated hospitals had adopted the new admissions procedure. As always, the coefficients table also gives us a standard error for this effect, a t-test for the null hypothesis that the effect is zero in the population, and a confidence interval. Back in the dialog box, we could go to the By If In tab to tell Stata we want to perform this analysis separately on groups of observations, or that we want to perform the analysis using only a certain range of observations. If the structure of our data requires it, we can go to the Weights tab and tell Stata which variable contains the weights that must be used in the analysis. And in the SE Robust tab, we can see that cluster robust standard errors will be computed by default, but we could instead ask for a different bias correction, or for bootstrap standard errors, or we could go to the Model tab to aggregate our data before computing standard errors, or to ask for a wild cluster bootstrap confidence interval. You can read about all these alternatives for inference in the full documentation of the command. We will not be going through a full example using panel data, because the dialog box, the commands, and the output are nearly identical, but there is one important step we would like to show you in this video. The new dataset I just opened is a panel dataset where the ID variable is called class ID, and it contains 65 observations for each of 7,248 types of chemicals. Each of these 65 observations corresponds to a year between 1875 and 1939, so year is our time variable in this panel. If we navigate again to statistics, causal inference treatment effects, continuous outcomes, difference in differences, and this time select panel data DID fixed effects, you'll notice the dialog box of the xtdidregress command has a new button at the top right for panel settings. This opens the dialog box for the xtset command, where we can tell Stata the panel ID variable is class ID and the time variable is year. We click OK, and we can see on the results window that Stata now understands the panel structure of this dataset and is ready to work. To look at worked examples with this and other panel datasets, and for more details about all these commands, remember you can always type help didregress into the command window and click on View Complete PDF Manual Entry. We hope this was helpful, and thanks for stopping by.